This is probably the most common problem that occurs after you try to install custom firmware on your 3DS. The blue light flashes, but you couldn't turn on the console. Don't worry, I will show you how to fix it in no time. So gamers, let's get started. Now remove the microSD card. Then download the latest version of Luma 3DS. The cause of this problem is, you missed the Luma 3DS boot.firm file at the root of the SD card. So open the Luma 3DS archive with WinRAR or 7-zip and extract the boot.firm file to the root of the SD card. Then reinsert the microSD card into the console. Then turn on the console. So there you go, it is back to life. Now I will show you how to turn on the console without the need of the SD card. Turn off the console for now. Remove the microSD card. Download the latest version of GodMod 9. Open the GodMod 9 archive and drag the GM9 folder into the root of the SD card. Replace the existing files and folder if any. Then navigate to the Luma folder, then open the payloads folder. Then drag the GodMod 9 firmware file into this folder. Replace the existing file if any. Now reinsert the microSD card into the console. Press and hold the start button, then press the power button. It will open the GodMod 9. Then press the home button and choose scripts. Then select GM9 Megascript. Then choose scripts from Prilex guide. And then choose setup Luma 3DS to CTR NAND. Press the A button twice, then input the combo keys. Press A, then press B, then select exit. Then press A to relock the NAND. Now press the home button and power off the system. Now remove the microSD card. Then turn on the console. Now you can boot the console without the need of the SD card. And you have come to the end of this video. I've shared you a little info, but useful for the 3DS owner. Thank you for watching and see you guys on the next video.